Hi, this is Ed from Wright. Today, John and I have set up a comparison demo of a EFI versus a carbureted engine. Starting off here, we have a Kohler ECV860. This is a purpose-built EFI engine. And on the side here, we've mounted a graduated cylinder showing the fuel. So right now, this cylinder starts with a quarter gallon of gas. And behind us, we have 6,000 square feet measured off. We're gonna cut this, it's in a small shape, so there will be turns, a little bit of different things going on, so we'll get probably a pretty average duty cycle of a small lawn, and we'll burn through maybe a pint of fuel. So we're gonna run this test here, then we're gonna go back to the shop, swap it with the FX850, and we're gonna do the second section. So we just cut 6,000 square feet of pretty tall growth down to 3.5 inches with this EFI engine. Used 475 milliliters, which is 0.1254 gallons, which is almost exactly a pint. We're gonna swap this engine, move over to the next section, and cut with a carbureted FX850. So we swapped engines, and now we have an FX850 on here. This engine has a little less horsepower and a little more displacement. We're gonna cut the 6,000 square feet and see how much fuel it consumes. We just finished cutting our second plot with this engine. This is a Kawasaki FX850 carbureted engine. This engine has a few more cc's of displacement and a little less power than the ECV860 we just ran on the other side. So this engine consumed 590 milliliters of fuel, and the Kohler consumed 470 milliliters of fuel.
So let's crunch the numbers. First, we'll talk our variables and our constants. Some of our constants were we had the same mower in both tests. The grass areas were identical, right next to each other, measured out to be exactly the same. Also, when John ran that test, he was able to run them both within just a few seconds of each other. So we really wanted to remove time from this, even though the one engine could have cut a little bit quicker. Our variables were the two engines, right? We had the carb, EFI. Both engines were broken in because a brand new engine's not gonna perform like it will later in its life. It's still breaking in. Now, for the numbers. If we take the difference in fuel consumed over our baseline, we get 19.5% fuel savings, which is pretty significant. That's almost 1/5. Now, it's probably more intuitive to look at this in gallons per hour, even though that might not be the best unit of measure here. But if we look at the 580 milliliters cut in 281 seconds, we get 2 gallons per hour. If we put in our EFI setup, we get 1.64 gallons per hour, and that difference comes to 0.36 gallons per hour. Now, if you take the 0.36 and you multiply it times the cost of fuel, which right now it's around 278. Also, 278 is a number that gives you exactly savings of $1 per hour, which is pretty compelling when you look at it this way. If you finance your mower, it's going to have an incremental increase, right? So the EFI will be a few hundred bucks, and it'll cost you $8 to $15 per month, maybe, say. And that incremental amount you have to pay every month can be recouped in your fuel savings within the first 8 to 15 hours of use that month. So if you're financing the machine, you can get positive cash flow pretty quickly, definitely before even you're paying your first payment. Now, a more meaningful unit of measure here is to look at gallons per acre. For example, you could have a really tiny mower and be trying to cut 10 acres, and your gallons per hour is going to be really low because the mower is tiny. But if you look at that in gallons per acre, it removes the time element of it and just says, how much fuel did it take to get the work done? Because number one importance is your labor or your potential to do more jobs. And so when looking and choosing for an engine, you want to first look at performance, power, torque response, cold start ability. You don't want to be tinkering with anything, right? So that's what you need to look at first. And second to that, you want to look at gallons per acre. Now, if we look at gallons per acre in this situation, we take our baseline over the 6,000 square feet and we convert it into gallons and acres, and we get 1.14 gallons per acre. And with the EFI engine, we get 0.92 gallons per acre. So the difference there is about 0.22 gallons per acre. So definitely it's doing more per acre. Now, if we had done these in two different time scales, we would have seen that we're still saving gallons per acre, but one would be consuming more gallons per hour. Now, some other benefits that come from this, an EFI engine has greater runtime. So for example, in the ZK that we showed in this test, with a carbureted engine, you'll get about 8 hours and 40 minutes. With EFI, you can get about 10 hours and 40 minutes. So that's an additional 2 hours. Also, an EFI engine is self-regulating. It's an air-cooled engine, but the conditions vary so much. You have hot days, cool days, you have high air pressure, low air pressure, humidity, and the EFI engine will continuously adjust for that. Whereas with a carbureted engine, it has to be tuned for that maximum hot condition, which is kind of a rich mixture. EFI is able to regulate that and control your engine's temperature, because as an air-cooled engine, it doesn't have a thermostat. So there's a few things about EFI. I hope this video was helpful to you. As you may have noticed, we've been developing our YouTube channel a bit more recently. And if there's any video topics that would be of particular interest to you, please comment below. Also, if you'd like to see when more videos come out, please subscribe. Thank you.